Welcome to the Expositor Podcast with Dr. Stephen J. Lawson. Dr. Lawson is the founder and president of One Passion Ministries. The Expositor Podcast is focused on taking your preaching to the next level. Now, here's Dr. Lawson.
This is Steve Lawson, and in this podcast, I want to speak on arguably the greatest preacher ever born on American soil. The man who is arguably the greatest theologian ever born on American soil, and the man who preached the greatest sermon, certainly the most famous sermon ever preached on American soil. By now you know of whom I speak, Jonathan Edwards. Jonathan Edwards was the pastor at Northampton, Massachusetts, in the church there, and was the main preacher among pastoral preachers in the Great Awakening in the 1730s and 1740s in the early colonies. He, along with George Whitefield, were the two prolific forces who preached in such a manner that God used it to ignite the Great Awakening. Jonathan Edwards was a most gifted preacher. And in this podcast, I want to isolate just one feature, one aspect of his preaching. And by way of segueing in, let me just say that he preached with very much of a Puritan style. He would take a passage of Scripture, and it would have a threefold division. Roman number one was always the text itself, opening up the meaning of the text, setting in its context and historical setting. Then the second Roman numeral would be the doctrine in this text, and he would extract, pull out the theological truths found in this passage and often go to cross-references and show how this doctrine is taught throughout the entire Bible. Then Roman numeral three would be the application, or what he would call the uses, and he would show the practical relevance of this passage, and he was a powerhouse as he would come to the application. In fact, one Edwardian scholar said that in the first two headings, as he would open up the text and draw out the doctrine, that he was merely rolling his canons into place, that he was merely putting the explosive gunpowder into the canon. But it was with the third Roman numeral, with the practical application, that Edwards fired his canons. And his preaching came so alive and became so powerful as he would challenge the listeners in acting upon the truths that had been preached in this message. I can certainly say, as I've read the sermons of Jonathan Edwards, and I've been privileged to read many of them, it certainly has that effect, that the sermon is just building and escalating to that third main heading of the application in which his exhortations are just so motivating and persuasive. Some of those are just etched in my own mind and are a part of my Christian life as they continue to speak to me. Edwards was a master at applying the Scripture to the life of the listener. But one aspect that I'd like to zero in on in this podcast is much like what I have done with Martin Lloyd-Jones. And perhaps this is where Lloyd-Jones picked up this emphasis. Jonathan Edwards was predominantly a big God preacher. I mean, he preached the greatness of God, and that came through loud and clear in his preaching. And Martin Lloyd-Jones called Edwards a God-dominated preacher. That's what I need to be. That's what you need to be. That to sit under our preaching, you sense that the preacher is dominated by God, and he's imposing this eternal weight of glory upon us as we come under the full force of who God is. This is what we need in our lives. We need to recognize more of God in our lives. George Marsden, who wrote One of the best biographies on Jonathan Edwards said of his preaching, "Edwards always begins with God," close quote. What a sentence that is. A short sentence, but a potent sentence. Edwards always begins with God. Edwards understood in his preaching that God must be understood for who He is before we can understand what sin is, before we can understand what salvation is, before we can understand who we are and what lies before us in the grave and beyond the grave. Everything must begin with God. Mark Knoll said that Edwards had a God-entranced world view, and that he was dominated by the primacy and the preeminence of God. That's the way our preaching must be, that when we stand at the back of the church after church is over and people are walking out and they want to speak to us, the greatest compliment that we will receive is not, "Pastor, that was a great sermon," or, "Pastor, you're a great preacher." The greatest commendation we will ever hear is for people to say, "Pastor, what a great God we have. Ever since you came to be our pastor, God in my mind is becoming bigger and greater and more glorious." That certainly was the effect of the preaching of Jonathan Edwards, and I pray that it'll be the effect of your preaching upon those who hear your expositions. May you be a big God preacher, be God dominated, be God entranced, and for that influence to be upon your congregation. God bless you as you preach like Jonathan Edwards.